Hello and welcome back to another Alternate Economy Wednesday. Sorry, I was just checking on my screen there, got a little sidetracked. I hope y'all are having an excellent Wednesday. We're halfway through now the Greater Reset, and of course, boo the Great Reset. We don't want that put on by the World Economic Foundation, the WEF. So I hope everybody's been tuning in to what's been going on with the Greater Reset. I hope everybody feels some good energy towards it. I know I do myself. I feel reinvigorated and I feel ready to move forward and start establishing freedom, I guess, really. That's what it boils down to. So I hope everybody else is having a good night, and thank you all for joining me. I do appreciate that. Anti-Zionist King, my friend, nice to see you. Thank you for the diamond, much appreciated. You guys hear me all right tonight? I readjusted my microphone. I got a different stand. And I don't think it was putting the microphone in the right spot. So I went back to the old one, at least for now. So hopefully it sounds a little bit better. Hopefully you can hear me a little bit better over the microphone. All right. So I guess to start off with, I just kind of wanted to show a couple of clips from, I guess, both. Like I said, tonight's show is about comparing and contrasting the views for voluntary. Thank you, Oregon Road. Nice to see you. All right, thanks. Is about contrasting and comparing the two, you know, the Great Reset versus the Greater Reset. You know, the Great Reset is the technocratic state, just controlling every aspect of our lives through medical passports, things like that, to be able to just go out and continue the lives we used to have, even just to go back to something like that. But even then, it's not, we know it's not going back to something like that. So versus freedom, which is what the Greater Reset is about finding your own way and building strong communities, smaller groups that really focus on helping each other out and being there for each other. And then, you know, helping each other when someone else comes to try to take their freedom as well. So that's a big part of it. I've had a lot of fun really connecting with people in the Freedom Cells group here in my area that we started. It's been really fun meeting new people, people from all different walks of life. But we all connect on the fact that we just want to be left alone and we just want to be able to do our thing. We're not hurting anyone. We're not taking anyone's property or damaging it. We're not defrauding anyone. We just want to be left alone. Right, Anti-Zionist King. All right, so I have, I guess here, let me get my everything pulled up here correctly. Bear with me, I apologize. Get rid of this, boo. I was just using YouTube for the intro music there. So here's the Greater Reset, thegreaterreset.org, the website set for it. So you can go here to get all the speakers that they've had every day. Here's links to the different platforms they use. I suggest using these ones. Most of them are pretty good. Odyssey here. BitChute is a really good one. It seems like they're under attack pretty good again right now, so be careful with BitChute. I mean, support them for sure. Just make sure you're supporting these content creators on other channels as well, because BitChute might get taken down. You never know. Float.app is kind of a cool, I've just kind of started messing with it a little bit. It's kind of a neat alternative to Facebook. I think it's blockchain-based as well, so I like that one pretty good. And then, of course, DLive, you can follow all their live streams here as well as the float.app. So make sure you check them out there. Let's see, I'll try to remember to get a link thrown up there in the description. But in the meantime, I am going to start playing a video. This is Derek Bros. He's one of the, he's like a co-creator, I guess. Him and John Bush created the Greater Reset. They just kind of got together and started this idea and started talking to other people, if you want to call that creating it. So I just want to play a little bit here from a little bit of a talk he gave on the opening night of the Greater Reset. It's called It's Time to Exit and Build. And so all these are focused on, you know, we've already recognized what the problem is, so we need to focus on solutions and how to build something beyond you know, what we're being served by the World Economic Forum and the powers that be, the banking cartels, all that good stuff. you don't believe in fairy tales, anti-Zionist king? Why not, man? That's no fun. It's much easier just to believe in fairy tales and believe in coincidences and all this stuff and then just do what you're told and get be given your allotment. Isn't that just so much more fulfilling? I'm just kidding. All right, so I'm going to let this play here. I'm going to throw up links to the Greater Reset and to this while it's playing.
The point is that we need to get activated more than ever. I don't think I can reemphasize that. You're probably going to get tired of us hearing that word, saying that word activation throughout the week, but I don't think we can overemphasize that enough. Do you see any way that this is just going to turn around without us doing anything? There are trillions of dollars invested into this Great Reset plan, which is a part of a larger overarching plan, and they are working around the clock. These people are technocrats. They're social engineers. They've been at this for a minute now. It is us free, beautiful, powerful individuals who are kind of catching up and trying to figure things out, right? But I want to say this as well. We have our ancestors with us. We have our ancestors at our backs. How many of you stop to acknowledge that every single one of us is here right now because of the work that our ancestors did before us? If they didn't do the work they did to survive through those harsh times, wherever, whichever part of the world you're indigenous to, because you're all indigenous and it's important to recognize that, wherever you come from on this planet, our ancestors went through hell to make sure that we could be here alive. What kind of hell are we going to go through to make sure that the future generations, the seven generations and beyond, can thrive in? It might be difficult. There might be rough times ahead. I think most of us are anticipating that and seeing that. We're not blind to what we see in the world. But at the end of the day, we have to push past our doubts, fears, insecurities. Maybe some of you even felt a little bit of insecure about gathering in person or being around other people. You know, you thought maybe I'll just stay home and watch this by myself, or I'll just stay back at the hotel or whatever your situation is. We have to push past that. We all have doubts, fears, insecurities. We all have idiosyncrasies and hangups and things that we could obsess over. And I've spent plenty of time obsessing over them in my life. I've wasted too much time now. And maybe you resonate with that. It's time for us to not to ignore the pains we have, but to put a renewed effort to focus and heal as individuals and as a community, and to put more effort than we ever have to taking concrete steps today. The future of humanity literally depends on what we do. I mean, that might sound cliche, it might sound abstract. No, what you are doing today is going to affect the world that the coming seven generations. And I have six nieces and nephews, 10, 11 and under, and they're beautiful kids, and they're having to go to school wearing masks now. They're having to, you know, and their parents, my family, they're just working class people trying to make it. They can't afford to take the kids out of school. But if we build community, as we've seen with Freedom Cells and homeschooling pods, there's an opportunity, right? We have strength in numbers. This is where we have everything we need in our communities already. I've seen this over the last 10 years. I guarantee you guys, wherever you're from, we have all the resources we need. We just need to strengthen those bonds. So if we do nothing, then my nieces and your kids and your nephews and everybody else in your family, all the young ones that are coming and the young ones that haven't been born yet, are going to grow up in a world that is going to be very unlike the world that we grew up in and probably the world we want for them. And that's just the cold, hard truth. But the beauty of that is it presents an opportunity like never before. Is anybody else thankful to be alive at this time in history? I know I wake up every day thankful that, holy shit, I get to do something about it. I get to be alive for this.
All right, I'm going to stop it right there. You know, Derek is kind of an inspiration to me. He's one of the reasons I started my channel up. I started following him a while back. So I just really like the way he thinks. That's pretty similar to me, and I like what he said there at the end. I feel the same way. You know, I feel this is an opportunity like we haven't had in a long time. There's a big, you know, because there is what they're calling the Great Reset. It's, you know, they're resetting too, so it's a chance for us to put in our own reset. You know, what we want, what actually benefits us, our communities, and the people, rather than just a small group of individuals running this world. So I'm pretty excited about that, and hope you guys are too. I want to be able to discuss that in this show a little bit more. So I'm going to kind of carry on, but hopefully you guys feel the same way. If you feel the same way, if you're kind of excited about the opportunity that's presenting itself, give me a one. If not, I guess give me a two and find some inspiration. Hopefully this will give you some inspiration. What he said, like I said, I put the link to that video, that full video, if you want to go watch it. If you haven't been watching out what's going on with the greater reset, I encourage you to go. I'm at least that, but I, like I said, I put the link to the whole website there, so you can go check out all their videos there. The next one I'm going to show you is from thecorbettreport.com, one of my favorite websites. Corbett, James Corbett, is one of my favorite researchers. So this is your guide to the Great Reset. So let me get it pulled up to the right time here. There's a couple of sections I want to play here for you guys. The first one is Klaus Schwab, the creator, the founder of the World Economic Forum. So let me get that pulled up here at the right timestamp so we don't have to go through a bunch of stuff. There we go. All right, so this is just the beginning, at the beginning of James Corbett's video, Your Guide to the Great Reset. I'm going to throw a link up to that video while this is playing. I recommend go checking it out. It's an excellent video. It really gives you a great idea about what is behind the Great Reset and all the control mechanisms, really. I mean, I mean, if you don't think we're free now, which, I mean, we aren't, we're getting this Great Reset. I mean, there's not going to be anything that's not tracked. I mean, everything's tracked right now, but I mean, it's just the control mechanisms that are going to be in place to really keep us from doing anything unless we really walk the straight and narrow and do anything that we're anything and everything that we're told to do. Right? Anti-Zionist King, I'm glad you're with me, my friend. Right? I hear you, Anti-Zionist King, just patiently waiting for the apocalypse. Right? Okay, so let me go ahead and play this. Like I said, I'll throw the link up in the comments while it's playing here.
Go. Countries and people came together to shape the post-war global order, which brought us decades of peace, increased global cooperation, and prosperity to hundreds of millions of people around the world. The COVID-19 crisis has shown us that our old systems are not fit anymore for the 21st century. It has laid bare the fundamental lack of social cohesion, fairness, inclusion, and equality. Now is the historical moment, the time, not only to fight severe virus, but to shape the system for the need for the post-corona era. We have a choice: to remain passive, which would lead to the amplification of many of the trends we see today. Polarization, nationalism, racism, and ultimately increased social unrest and conflicts. But we have another choice. We can build a new social contract, particularly integrating the next generation. We can change our behavior to be in harmony with nature again. And we can make sure that the technologies of the fourth industrial revolution are best utilized to provide us with better lives. In short, we need a great reset.
I'm not sure whether that was meant to be hilarious or terrifying, but either way, I think Klaus Schwab should probably get in touch with his agent.
I agree with him there. I think that was a little bit of both, I think, is what it was meant to be. Yeah, it's a good observation. V is for voluntary, V for voluntary. The World Economic Forum logo there, I think it's what you're referring to, the curve where it comes down through the O's of world and econ and forum. It creates a 666. Is that what you're referring to? All right, let's see. We move on to the next one here. All right, so this next little clip here is kind of an advertisement for the fourth industrial revolution. It's from the same video from James Corbett. I'm just trying to get it to the right timestamp there so I don't waste a bunch of time. Here we go. That's about right.
Introduction. What is the fourth industrial revolution?
The original industrial revolution was driven by the discovery that you could use steam engines to do all kinds of interesting things.
But that was followed by additional revolutions for electricity and computers and communications technology. We're now in the early stages of the fourth industrial revolution, which is bringing together digital, physical, and biological systems.
One of the features of this fourth industrial revolution is that it doesn't change what we are doing, but it changes us.
With the ability to visualize brain activity, for example, through a simple consumer-based EEG device, it gives us access to ourselves in ways that we've never before thought possible. It unlocks the black box that is the brain and enables us to really, truly be able to realize an identity that is aspirational.
There's now a scientific foundation for the effects of mindfulness on the brain, on the genome, on biological aging. And when the human mind does know itself, then you get the potential for a new renaissance that restructures itself in terms of our relationship to life, our relationship to the planet, our relationship to work.
We need a different economic model. And by that, I don't mean capitalism versus communism. What I'm talking about is a shift in the system along the lines of the two big changes that happened in the 20th century, Keynesianism, with a much greater focus on health and education and the role of government working with business, and then a reaction against that in late century to neoliberalism, where the focus was on free markets, freedom of the individual, and getting governments out of the way. We need a shift to a new system that will allow us to meet the basic needs of every human on the planet, that will live within planetary means, that will be fairer, and that will be focused as its key goal, not on growth per se, but on maximizing human well-being. And history tells us that a value shift is triggered by creation of a new story about how we want to live.
All right, so I'm gonna stop playing that rest of, like I said, I threw up the link to that video in the comments section there, so go check it out. I'll throw it up in the description if you're watching this Thursday morning on 3Speak or Library or BitChute or one of my other platforms. If you are still watching me on YouTube, make sure you switch off. I'm not censoring myself, and I'm talking about a lot of things they don't want us to talk about, so it's not going to be long before I get another strike, I'm sure. Hey, Freedom Allegiance, thanks for joining us. He does look like Dr. Evil, you're right. All right, so I have another video a little bit I want to play from Dolores Cahill from today. Maybe she was from yesterday at the Greater Reset. But before I do that, like I said, today I kind of want to talk about the difference between the two. And so I had an experience today that's wrapped up in this whole the Great Reset and what's going on right now, especially with medical stuff. So my son, most of you know, he has cerebral palsy, and you know, his mother and I are divorced, so you know, obviously he splits time with us. And like today we had an appointment with his neurologist, and you know, right now all these hospitals are only allowing one of us in at a time for an appointment like that. And you know, that's one thing if it's just like the family doctor you're going to see for the annual checkup, you know, for one of the parents to go in. But it's not okay for you know, these appointments with like a neurologist in a hospital. That's not okay for our son. We need to both be there. He spends time with me and he spends time with her. And he's nonverbal, and it's so he has a hard time communicating, you know, what he's feeling, and he's having a lot of issues that we're trying to figure out what's going on right now. And it's really hard to do it when we can't both be in there. So, you know, his mom isn't as willing to push the envelope as me. She's not as willing to, you know, kind of say, hey, this isn't right, what's happening here. We need to, you know, you need to accommodate us and allow us in there. And it's not just us, it's every family. Every family should be in there advocating for their family member or friends, whoever is there as a representative, whoever that patient wants with them should be in there advocating for that patient. And that's not happening right now. So, you know, that was it was a bit of an issue today at the hospital, not allowing us both in, and it really got my my son's mom really upset for the first time about, you know, these restrictions that have been put on all these businesses by the state. You know, and the only reason most of these businesses, I don't know about the hospitals, they're doing it because of the money, because at least this hospital is a nonprofit, so it's doing it because of the money. But, you know, most of them are just doing it because of the threat of violence, the threat of extortion on, you know, from the government. So, you know, I just don't think that, I don't know. It was a strange day. That appointment was very strange. Of course, then the mood afterwards was very strange. We got to both go in there eventually after kind of pressing the issue. They let us in there. I think it was mainly just because I was calm, you know, my, so, you know, but it was interesting to see her get really upset for the first time that, you know, what's happening because of the rules of this system. Yeah, anti-Zionist king, you know, it's right. I mean, you know, my daughter wants to go back to school. And they're only allowing them one day. They have to be 12 feet apart. There's even, so, you know, there's like a desk every 6 feet. So they're only doing every other desk. So they're 12 feet apart. I mean, I keep telling her, what's the point of going? You're not going to be able to interact with your friends. You're not going to be close enough, right? And to be forced to wear a mask all day. You know, I told her, I showed her, hey, if you want to fight wearing the mask, I'll show you how to do it. But if you don't want to fight it, if you don't care, I'm not going to do it. You know, hopefully she cares enough to fight it. So far she said no, but I think once she starts going, I think she's going to be disappointed, right? Yeah, it's pretty sad. So, you know, the medical, you know, education, we kind of went over that a little bit last week. The medical aspect of it, you know, where are we going to get medical care from, you know, if we're not going to comply with these new rules? Where are we going to get our medical care? Because we're already starting to get squeezed out of getting medical care if we don't want to, you know. My son, they don't question him at all when he doesn't wear a mask, but they do, of course, me. And just so I can, so because it's my son and the situation with his mom, since we're divorced and all that, just so I can get him the care he needs without causing a deal, you know, between the whole family. I just wear a mesh mask when I go in there. It hasn't been a big deal. So, except for today, I didn't, because I didn't, you know, she, at first she wasn't as upset and she wanted to just, she said, oh no, we'll just do like a Zoom call, one of us. And then when we got there, she was upset. So I didn't have my mesh mask with me. I don't keep it with me because I don't use it except for places like that. So she didn't have it. I didn't have it with me. So I had to use a regular mask to be able to go in for the appointment. And I thought that was important. So there you go. Yeah, I hear you. Sorry, I'm just trying to read a couple of the comments here. Yeah, it's not cool to have to do that. You know, I mean, we should all have choice. That's the main thing. You know, everything is being forced on us. And I think the most important thing, like my point with what happened to my appointment today, with my son's appointment today, is, you know, without both of us there, we can each advocate for him. And it's really hard to do it through these stupid, silly Zoom things. It's just, you're not as attentive. It's through a computer instead of right there with the doctor. So it's not okay. It's hard to advocate. And, you know, the same thing, like if, you know, one of my friends, her mom was in the hospital up north of here in a smaller town. And like the rules were, if you left the room, only one visitor. And if you left the room, you couldn't go back. Like what happens if something happened when the visitor had left? So they couldn't go back in there. What happens if something would have happened, you know, to her mom, and there's no one in there to advocate for her with the doctors and the nurses? I mean, I know the doctors and the nurses, I'm not saying they're bad people, but they they work within the rules of the system that employs them. So, you know, they do that, and we know the system is bad. We know the system is corrupt. So it's just we need friends and relatives to be able to access these hospitals and these doctors' offices, to be able to advocate for the patients, to be able to advocate for their friends and their, you know, their loved ones. You know, this is what building these communities is about, is helping each other figure out how to do this. So yeah, I think you can get a physical on Zoom, Anti-Zionist King. So, you know, I don't know if any of you guys have any ideas. I got the phone number up there if anyone wants to call in, or if you just want to do some messages on the comments there, I'll start reading some of those out. You know, one of the things in our meeting on Sunday that was brought up on our voluntarist meeting here in Eastern Washington that we have every Sunday here in Liberty Lake, it was brought up that, you know, most of our, the drugs that we take, the pharmaceutical drugs that we take, are derived from plants. And then now they've just been the what was taken from the plant, or the, you know, whatever it was in the plant that helped us, has now just been synthesized in a lab. And that's how we create a lot of our drugs now. So obviously we know opiates come from the poppies. So that's why we're in the Middle East, we're in Afghanistan. So, you know, I think we just need to start looking back to some different alternatives. You know, I remember reading, I'll try to search it up here real quick. It was a while back, a few years ago, where the Chinese were buying up all these patents and copyrights and all these companies, not patents, I guess, but all these companies that make natural, like, drugs, not natural drugs, but, you know, natural healing solutions and things like that. So maybe I'll see if I can find something on that real quick. Yeah, right? Freedom Allegiance? You know, I agree. That's, I mean, I haven't talked to a whole lot of doctors. My son's neurologist actually was very, very cool about it. She seems to be pretty reasonable. When this all started, she was asking us about schooling for, like, our daughter and our son. And, you know, she pulled her daughter and sent her to a private school just so she could go to school and be in school in person. But she said, you know, that was, most of the doctors aren't doing that. Most of the doctors, at least where she works, are, you know, keeping their kids out of school and not sending them. So V for voluntary, thank you for the ninja gini. Holy cow, I appreciate that. Thank you. Wow. I agree. I guess, you know what? I guess maybe from now on, I just came over to DLive to start building up my audience here. Maybe I'll still use, I've noticed there's a couple of platforms I can use, or a couple of streaming services that'll stream to multiple platforms. So I won't just be on one. Maybe I'll start figuring one of those out. That's one more thing for me to learn, right? So that then I can just stream to multiple applications. I think there's one of them I can do like to three. Float.app, I think that's probably the one I'm just going to start doing all my live streams to. It's the one that's kind of like a new Facebook. I'll probably just start doing them to that. Because, yeah, it seems like DLive is starting to get everyone. What'd you say, Anti-Zionist King? They demonetize The Last American Vagabond and High Impact Flicks. And no more news. Wow. Oh, and more, huh? Yeah, I heard that they did a few more. So, yeah, I don't know, guys. I guess that's why I keep saying you got to start following all your favorite content creators on multiple platforms and encouraging them to get onto multiple platforms. Because, I mean, you know, the noose is just going to get tighter and tighter. It's not going to get bigger. So we need to start preparing for that, so that if you don't see me, if you follow me on YouTube and you don't see me upload something to YouTube for a week, maybe go look at me on my BitChute channel, or 3Speak, or DLive, or DTube. There's so many, or Float.app, or Let's see, what else did I miss there? Library, Odyssey, those two are the same. I really like Library and Odyssey. They're really cool. I like ThreeSpeak a lot. It's a really good one as well. So go subscribe to me on those ones if you haven't there. You know, that's another way to beat this is we have to keep information flowing. So make sure you guys are sharing this stuff on if you're on any kind of social media. I know most of us probably aren't because we don't really like it. But if you are, make sure you're sharing this with your friends and family to get the word out. Yeah, it seems like people that aren't order followers in the medical industry, just like in every other aspect, just like in law enforcement, they're going to have to start just leaving because it's, you know, I know one of my friends that already did. She went to school to become a nurse and went through school and basically decided, I can't do this. I don't want to be just a button pusher that says this symptom, and gets a printout of, you know, how to handle the situation. So unfortunately, that's kind of where we're at with modern day medicine, and it's only getting worse. Let's see. Here we go. This is from, let's see when this is here. This is from the Parapundit. I don't know how good this, yeah, from 2010. So that was a while ago I saw that. Yeah, but it's just a few articles here saying that the Chinese are buying up natural resources. Never mind. That was not a good source. I'm not gonna use that one. Disregard that. Right. So like a freedom medical practice, what is that? You know, it's like that could look like a group of doctors, just like we have now different groups. But instead of a group of doctors that does one kind of concentration, maybe you'd have to have a group that has doctors in many different fields. Kind of like we, you know, in a hospital is where a bunch of different doctors go to the hospital from different fields. So maybe that's what we need, is some sort of a group like that, where we have a doctor that's, you know, a family practice doctor, but maybe then a couple other doctors that specialize in other things. And then, of course, you know, I mean, eliminating insurance. I mean, everybody, I mean, that's 20% just administrative costs right there when you go to the doctor. So just eliminating that is 20% of the costs right there. I would imagine it's more than that, because that's just the administrative cost of insurance is like 20% of the insurance, I guess. But, you know, the insurance themselves, like, here's an example. My son has a device that he uses to communicate. We call it his bird brain rather than his, I can't even think of what the clinical name is for it right now. I haven't said it in such a long time. An augmented speech device, I think, is what it's called. We just call it his bird brain because we like to have fun. It's kind of an inside joke. Anyhow, he uses it to talk. It's an iPad that has a little program that he downloaded to it. Well, when we first bought it, we have purchased two of them through the company. It's called Dynavox. Let me get it pulled up here while I'm talking about it. And so Dynavox makes these devices, and Dynavox is owned by Johnson & Johnson. And when you go through insurance, you go through, you know, through a speech pathologist, and they help you write a prescription and get everything lined up to go through insurance to get this through Dynavox. And so what they do is they make their own device. And so at first it was this big clunky thing, but then the second one we got was more like an iPad. But the entire thing with the software was like $8,000. And with that, we got the software on the device, and then we got some companion software that we could download to like an iPad or any, like a Surface or a computer, but or like a desktop computer, but not an Android tablet, even though it's an Android system. Anyhow, $8,000. I think it was just over $8,000 for this, basically a tablet. And of course, it was a medical device. That's why it was so expensive. Well, the warranty on it was about a year. And every time, right about the time the warranty was up, oh, it'd go bad. And oh, that was right about the time, coincidentally, that insurance would pay for another one. Well, we got sick of that happening and we looked into it. Well, you can buy the program for $250 through the iTunes, you know, through the App Store and just download it to your iPad. So you can go buy like a used iPad for like 150, 200 bucks and just download it, buy the program for like 250. So you're like, what? That's $350, $400 into it now. That's it. And rather than paying this huge deductible or if you have a copay or something like that with your insurance on this $8,000 device and then insurance just collecting all this or Johnson & Johnson just collecting all this insurance money because it's a medical device, it's insane. It's really insane. So, you know, and how many people just, you know, because we have two sets of insurance for my son, a lot of our copay is usually taken care of with stuff like that. So, you know, the inclination of his mom at first was just, well, let's just get the one through Dynavox. It won't cost us anything. And I'm just like, yeah, but is that okay? Look at how much that costs. And why is that? You know, I mean, that's just ridiculous that it costs so much just because it's through them. And like I said, their device is, it's in my opinion, it's worse than an iPad. It doesn't work as good. And in today's day and age, you have to pay an extra $50 on their device to be able to access the internet, even though it's a tablet. It's literally an Android tablet. Their program runs on, it's an Android program. So there you go. Anyways, there's my rant about that. I'm sorry. I'll get down off my soapbox now. I'm trying not to keep, let these go super long. I'm already over 38 minutes. So Anti-Zionist King. You know, I really have a hard time with the medical field because they are, you know, Freedom Allegiance, you said that earlier. And that's my biggest struggle is, you know, the people in there just, you know, just like I think a lot of cops think they're doing the right thing, even though they're not. They're threatening violence against us every day and we haven't done anything wrong. I think, you know, a lot of these doctors, I mean, they are, they're trying to do the right thing. That's why they went into it. They want to help people. They want to help sick people get healthy. But when the entire system that you've been trained by is evil and is set up to make us sick and all the treatments that we get and the research, it's all the way back to how the research is done. I mean, I could go on and on with stories. My uncle used to do research for a biomedical research foundation in San Antonio, Texas, the Southwest Foundation for Biomedical Research. And, you know, he would talk to me about how he did his studies. He would, you know, in order to get funding from, there was a German pharmaceutical company that was giving him funding. So he had to write his studies in order to get funding from them. He had to write his studies to kind of give them the information that they wanted in order to keep giving him money, so that then he could use their money to do the studies they wanted to do, but also fund his research. So, you know, this science is junk science. If these scientists are developing studies to give these companies the answers they want so that they'll keep getting funding for their own research, you can't trust the science. So, wow. Yeah, V for voluntary. That's a good point, too. You know, you pointed that out a couple weeks ago to me, not to call it a vaccine. And, you know, we shouldn't because it's an mRNA injection. Just call it that. So that's crazy that your doctor was pushing it today, huh? Yeah. Yeah, they do. They believe. That's right. So, right? Freedom Allegiance. You know, and that's the problem is when you do speak up, you know, it's so much easier to just go with the flow. It is hard to be the rebellious one and speak up. So I encourage you to keep doing it. And if we can find someone to help you someone for you to practice under that's a freedom doctor, that'd be awesome. I know in one of our groups here, someone contacted us. They're from the other side of Washington State over in the Seattle area. But she's a nurse and she contacted our group just because she was looking for some like-minded people. And she, you know, said, yeah, hopefully my skills will come in handy sometime because she's fed up with the system, hasn't worked in it for over a year because of some injuries, she said. But it's interesting. People are starting to just say, you know what, I'm done. And so maybe those people will start getting together and creating some sort of a way for us to stay healthy. I mean, most of us know how to stay healthy, eat right, take care of your body, stuff like that. But, you know, we all get sick, and especially as we get older, our body starts to break down. So, right, anti-Zionist key? Yeah, we already are terrorists. You know, it's funny, at one of the meetings that I have, last two weekends, I've had two meetings, one on Saturday and one on Sunday at my house. And at one of the meetings, a couple of the people came up and they, you know, kind of were concerned about being on a list. And, you know, I mean, I don't really know what to tell people. That's where we're at. If you desire freedom in any shape or fashion, then yes, you're going to be on a list, because the new normal does not allow for freedom. I mean, they pretty much have told us that. So, anyhow, I'm going to end the stream. I hope you guys had an excellent night. Thank you for joining me. V for voluntary. Thank you for donating the rest of your lemons. So yeah, I'll look into that for next week and see if I can get on multiple platforms. So I'll be back here next week, of course, but we'll get on multiple platforms so that you guys can follow me wherever you want when I do this and not have to wait for the next morning. But I appreciate you guys hanging out with me here on DLive. Like I said, I'm going to keep coming back here until they kick me off, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I should treat them just like YouTube. Well, I guess I'll have to think about that a little bit. But like I said, I am on float.app here. Let me get that pulled up real quick. Go check that out. It's pretty cool. It's, like I said, it's blockchain-based. It's social media. I'm just going to throw the link to float.app here up in the description. Go check that out, and I'll do some live streams there. I was actually thinking, like, when I go out cop watching and stuff, I'm gonna start doing that again. I'll probably use float.app for my live streams. You can do that right from your phone, although I'm trying to get rid of my phone, so I've been leaving it home. I would encourage you to do that. If you're not just getting rid of it, at least leave it at home. Don't take it with you. Anyways, thanks for joining me, guys. I appreciate it. Like I said, go check out float.app, follow me there. I think I'm Question Authority. Let me just make sure. Yeah, Question Authority. You know, a lot of these platforms, they won't allow the full Questionable Authority, so I usually do it like here. It's Question Authority, same as on float.app. So there's the link to my float.app page, I guess. So go check me out and follow me there. You guys have an excellent rest of your night. Thanks for joining me. Anti-Zionist King, thank you for the lemons. Thank you for the, let's see, what'd you, so that was a ninja, that's right. I always forget what they are here. A diamond, I'm sorry. A ninja genie is what V for Voluntary sent me. So thank you guys for all your time. I appreciate you guys' support and following me here. Like I said, I'll be back here next Wednesday for sure, so you can still follow me here. But you guys have an excellent rest of your night, and don't forget to live free.